Apple again. So today I'm going to do a video based on watercolors. I recently went out to my local Michaels store and picked up some new watercolor supplies. The ones that I had been using previously were very chalky and I couldn't really layer them on themselves, and they would often kind of scratch off if I layered the paint too much. So I decided it was time for some new watercolors since I'd been wanting to get more into watercolor lately. So I'm going to go over the two brands that I purchased, and then I'm going to do a quick speed paint with them while I talk a little bit more about watercolor. So the first thing that I picked up were these metallic watercolors. They're by Yasutomo Niji, and they're called pearlescent watercolors. This is the set of 21, so it comes with a wide variety of colors. I got these at my local Michaels craft store, but they're also sold on Amazon.com. They're fairly inexpensive. I bought at Michaels, they were being sold for $10, but everything there is always overpriced, and then you can use coupons. So I ended up getting them for about $5, but on Amazon I think they're about the same, about $6. So fairly inexpensive, and they have a really nice shine to them. It's kind of hard to see on camera, but you can see that they have a very nice metallic look. So I got these because I want to do some experimenting with them and some nice detailing. So I'm excited to use these. And then the second thing that I picked up while I was there was these Sakura Koi watercolors. This is the Pocket Field Sketch Box, and it comes with 24 half pans of watercolor. So it also came with this watercolor brush, which I already had one, but I didn't expect it to come with a brush, so that's really nice. This one was a little more expensive. Like I said, at Michaels it's always marked up. So it was $38 at Michaels, and I was able to use a half off coupon. So I got them for about $19, but they retail online for about $20. So not too bad, because the quality of these watercolors is really nice. This pan on top, when you open it, comes out, and you can put it on any of these little, in any of these little holes here, so you can kind of move it around to where you want it to be, and it's a nice little mixing tray. Then it comes with the 24 half pans, which I've never actually owned a really nice watercolor set before, so when I was testing each of these colors out to make a little palette for myself, the watercolors were really, really smooth, and I really liked how pigmented they were compared to the gross watercolors I was using before. So each side of this comes with a little sponge that you can use to kind of dry off your brush in between colors. And yeah, I'm really excited to use these to create a painting. So like I said, they weren't too expensive for the quality you get, and just to see a little swatch of each of the colors, I kind of roughly made little swatches of them, but yeah, really pigmented, and I'm excited to see how they work together. So I'll start by talking a bit about the products that I used in this video. None of this was sponsored, just to put that out there. I went out and bought these myself with my money, so nobody's paying me to say any of this. I'm just giving an honest review. So for the Sakura Koi watercolor set, I really enjoyed that it is a completely portable set. So basically you can just pick this up and your watercolor paper and go, and you don't have to worry about any other materials. Since it comes with the watercolor brush inside of it, it's got an area for you to dry your brushes in between uses, and it's got an area for you to mix your paints. And each of these paints are really, really pigmented. As I was using it, and you'll see it throughout the video, I was having a very easy time layering colors on top of themselves to make them darker and more vibrant. And the result is really beautiful, in my opinion. I like the range of colors that they give you. The one thing I will say is they do give you a lot of reds that all seem to be a bit similar. One is a bright red, and then there's two that are kind of similar, and then one that's more of a pinkish red. So I just felt they gave a lot of those, but other than that, I guess that's fine since I tend to use those colors a lot anyway, so for me it works. But yeah, the range of colors is very nice. Additionally, when I saw the white watercolor paint in there, like I said, I'm not very good at watercolors as is. I'm pretty new to it, so I'm still learning, and I've never had a white watercolor before, I guess. I guess I thought it wouldn't really have pigment in it, but it turned out that when I ended up mixing it with other colors,
it really does lighten them and you can actually see the white paint. So I guess I expected it to be more, less opaque, I should say. So yeah, that was something I really liked. Additionally, with the metallic colors, the pearlescent ones, you can tell that they are a cheaper quality since they were only $10 for 21 colors and online $6. So really it's not the highest quality. I think Fine Tech is one of the higher quality ones, but I don't own those, so I can't say how they work personally. But I really enjoyed using the metallic orange on the tail because it really shimmers when you hold the paper at a certain angle. You can really see the shine on the paper. It's really cool. And the fact that it came with so many different colors that are metallic was just a plus for me, and it was the incentive of buying it. So I definitely recommend getting both palettes because for about $25 in total, you can get both the Sakura Koi watercolors for all the regular basic watercolors that you'd need, and then the pearlescent ones, which are inexpensive and also come with a nice variety of colors. And like I said, they're not the most opaque and best quality, but they are very good quality still, in my opinion. So I would definitely recommend both of these brands if you're looking for watercolors to use and you don't want to spend a ton of money, or if you're new. So yeah, that's just my two cents on the materials. So now I'll talk a bit about the actual drawing itself. So I started by trying to brainstorm what I was going to draw because I wanted to showcase these new watercolors and practice with them, but I wasn't sure what to draw. Basically started with a blank slate. So I was thinking water, flowiness. I wanted to really see the colors, I guess, blend into themselves a lot. Like I wanted to do a background where I could just put a ton of colors together and have them all blend. And what made me think of that was then water. So I thought to do an underwater scene, and that's what inspired me to do a mermaid because I knew I could definitely use the shiny colors that I got on the tail and accents and things like that to give a nice cool effect with that. And then I could also play around with a lot of different colors and have a flow in the picture. So that's where the idea for this drawing came from. And yeah, the colors were basically randomly chosen, except for the orange, because I was thinking of goldfish when I started drawing this, so I decided to do her with more of an orangey theme on her tail, along with the fish around her. And then as for the other colors in this, I just tried to pick colors that went well with the orange without being too overbearing in the image overall. So that was my thought process on choosing colors. And then for coloring her in, basically I tried a bunch of different techniques, like putting a lot of water down on the page in certain areas and then taking some color from the palette and dropping it on top and watching it slowly make a gradient. So I did that a lot on her, I guess, fins, the frills on her upper part of her tail. I don't know what to call that. It's I tried to show that kind of effect while also having other areas where I just colored in flat color. And one thing that I really like about the watercolors is that you can kind of be a little bit messy with them, but they still tend to look good because watercolors in themselves tend to blend here and there, and they can kind of have a messy look. And like I said, they still look good. In my opinion, I like that look. Toward the end of the drawing, I went in with my black Copic multiliners and I went over all of the red pencil so that I could show the outline of her more prominently, because my idea was to kind of sketch everything out in red pencil and then just paint straight over that, because if I was to put the marker down first and then paint over it, it would have just bled, because I've made that mistake in the past and I've had issues with bleeding. I don't know if I guess it doesn't matter on the type of watercolors you use. I guess it matters on the water mixing with the marker itself. So yeah, I didn't want to take any risks. So I decided just to do the sketch in red And I didn't care if some of the red lines were seen because I kind of liked that messy look in this drawing since it was watercolor and I wanted it to have a messy finish. I didn't want everything to be perfect because I tend to do that sometimes and try to make every line perfect, but I really want to try to not always worry about that and just have fun with it. So yeah, that's why I went in at the end and I did all the outlines along with some of the detailing with my Sakura Jelly Roll pen. And I noticed that it was harder to see it on the metallic colors, but I think that was just because I colored in orange and it was just hard to see. I mean, at first it was kind of hard to get the ink out onto that one, but it was easier after a while, so it might have just been me.
So everyone, that is my finished watercolor painting. I hope you guys enjoyed watching me paint it. I would definitely recommend both of these palettes for anyone who's either starting in watercolor or is looking for an alternative to some of the more expensive brands. I'm definitely still new at watercolor and I have a lot of practice to do, but this piece was really fun for me and I had a lot of fun playing around with all of the different colors. So one thing I really like about watercolor is that you can kind of be a little bit messy and outside the lines and it still looks natural. So I just had a lot of fun with it. So if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more art related videos like this, please subscribe, leave a like, comment below, and I will see you guys in my next video. Have a beautiful day. Bye bye.